We're getting to our entertainment portion. I'm excited to be able to introduce our comedian to all of you. Omar Reagan was born and raised in Detroit. He started writing songs at the age of 9 and debuted on the professional music scene at the age of 11. How many 11-year-olds in here? Any 11-year-olds? Okay, a few, there we go, nice. So he was part of a group called SOA. And SOA opened for renowned artists, including Redman, Method Man, and Eminem. In 1999, SOA was offered a record deal, but they held out hoping for more, and it actually fell through. And I think it was divine guidance that fell through. Because then, Reagan jumped on the stage as a stand-up comedian. And ever since then, he's realized what his true passion is. And that's when he left Detroit for Hollywood. He was offered and accepted the role as photo double for Chris Tucker in Rush Hour 2. And you'll see this resemblance when he gets up here a little bit. In 2005, Reagan appeared on E's reality series, Fight for Fame. And Reagan now is internationally known. He's appeared in numerous places, including in films. He founded his own production called Hollywood, which is a great name. And he uses entertainment and humor to promote tolerance, diversity, and to build bridges across racial, religious, and social divides. So let's put our hands together and give a very warm welcome to our comedian, Omar Reagan.
Man, we almost got up to a milli, huh? That was nice. Shit. May Allah bless you. Y'all say Ameen?
Ameen.
May Allah bless your family. Say Ameen.
Ameen.
May Allah increase your wealth, health, happiness, love for you and everybody that you love. Say Ameen.
Ameen.
May Allah also give you $1 million. Ameen. He liked that one. He says Ameen. All right. So let me see. Where's my non-Muslims? Are we still here? They ran away. All right, let me see who else is here. Is my Arabs here? Wait, let me see. Is the Arabs here? I can't. How many Arabs? واحد اثنين ثلاثة أربعة خمسة ستة سبعة ثمانية ثمان عشرة يعني من سوريا. الحمد لله. Let's give it up for سوريا, man. سبحان الله. May Allah bless Surya, subhanAllah, may Allah bless you. Yani, Habibi, I love it. I want to speak Arabic, man, all the time. I say, where's my Arabs? All I know is, Yani, Habibi, Wallahi al-Azim, Wallah, Wallah. And then, I love it, the Arabs, they always use Yalla. Now, when I was studying, I didn't know what yalla meant. I'd be on the phone, they always be like, okay, yalla, bye. I said, what? Yalla, bye. I was like, yellow. I thought he was haram. I know, it's in my head. Let me see, where's my Somalians here? Somalia, I know. What are you? Look at all of my brown people. What is happening? What's going on now? Is that a black thing? Let me see who else is here. Is my Indonesians here? Yes! I love my Dutch! Yeah, Tarimakasi! Is there any Chinese people? Oh, ni hao ma. Let me see. Is it any other Arab? We have Syria, Lebanese, Yemeni,
Egypt.
Muslim, Egypt? I know. All right, let me see. Is anybody from India, Pakistan, Bangladesh? Let me see if they're really here. Let me see. 世界越高，昨夜加那萨南，亚伯达夫迪巴那萨南。
I know. I got to do a shout out. Hold on.
Chala kila bara pire.
I know.
I know, y'all looking at me like, what is he? Is he black? Is he really black? Where is he from?
TJ Baker.
Oh man. Is there any just black people here? See, the Somalians always claim that twice. Alhamdulillah. You know why I love this? Because subhanAllah, they have said it many times. We are just so diverse. We're here, we're doing something so good. And especially, like, I'm really proud of you guys. So while I'm up here, even in the beginning, I want to say shukran to MAPS for having me and inviting me back. This is the second time I've been to Seattle. Alhamdulillah, I love it here. So give it up for MAPS. Oh man, where's that chef that was leading the prayer? Where is that guy? Did y'all feel the prayer? That guy, may Allah bless him. Man, you ever prayed and you just really felt like your iman just started going up? Like, man, this is a good prayer right here. You know, you ever, like, really, it helps you have concentration in your prayer. Because me, I be having issues in my prayer, right? When I start praying, is it just me? As soon as I start making salat, shaitan come. I said, Allahu Akbar, shaitan says, hey, Umar. I said, hey, shaitan. And now shaitan is reminding me about everything in salat, and I'm just doing the motion. I'm like, Allah. Shaitan is, hey, Umar, yeah, you forgot to do this. I'm like, that's right. And it never fails. When I come from ruku, shaitan always say, do you have wudu? And then I look and I say, do I? I don't know. And I'm standing there and I'm trying to remember if I have wudu or not. Maybe I should just get out of the salat. I don't know what I should do. And then I'm thinking, I don't want to go in the back of the row. And then I'm like, I have to do something because I'm the imam. I know. Shaitan, man, this guy is always doing that, just distracting. So for me, you know what I like to do? I say, I'm going to beat Shaitan. When Shaitan comes and whispers in my ear, I'm just going to start my Fatiha all over again so I can concentrate in Salat. So I start, alhamdulillah, and I just concentrate. Shaitan says, hey, Umar. I said, hey, Shaitan. Oh. And I get him to Iyaka na'budu wa Iyaka nasta'een. Hey, Umar. I said, hey, Shaitan. Oh. I got all the way up to what I mean. Hey, Umar said, hey, Shaitan. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. You know, the people was watching me make salah. They said, MashaAllah. He must be reciting Surah Al-Baqarah. If they only knew. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Like, for me, like, I really start realizing that concentration in salat can change our life. You feel me? It really can. But I have some of the most I have some of the most interesting challenges in my concentration. So I was making salat, and the brother, he was leading the prayer, right? So beautifully. He was reciting this surah. He was like, wa ilayhi turja'oon. Now, I was making salat because I wanted to No, alhamdulillah, I'm working on it. I'm inspired by that party, that sheikh, right? So I'm praying and I'm listening to this Quran. This Quran is going so good and my eyes is closed. So when he says this ayah, and he says, turja'oon. My eyes was closed, and you know how that sounds like. We about to go into ruku. So I was like, Allah, like, right? And then he says, yeah. I was like, oh no. I felt like my iman went extremely down because I went into ruku before the imam. I was like, oh Allah, help me. and I wanted to look like this, and I wanted to look over here, and I was like, no! I just had to say, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. And I want to change this thing here. You see how beautiful the Quran sounds? Do you see it? The Quran makes it feels enlightened. It feels so strong. It feels so good, right? Is it just me? Let me see. You guys don't like the Quran? Does the Quran make you feel good? Okay, yeah, okay. Whew, I got scared. I thought I was about to say, I do? I was like, man, I'm glad. So the Quran made me feel so good. So I'm listening to Quran, and then I'm just listening, alhamdulillah, and he's just reciting, Ya Yohannes. I was like, oh, yes, 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 right? And then the English guy came on, it scared me. Mankind. I was like, whoa! I was like, why does he sound so scary? So I said, I want to change that. Why can't the English sound just as good as the Arabic? Y'all agree? I mean, I think it should just be nice because the Quran makes me feel so good. This guy, even if he said, Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Then the English guy comes on and messes everything up. In the name of Allah. Oh, like, oh.
The most gracious, most merciful.
No! I said, cut the Arabic off, cut the English off. I want to just listen to the Arabic. So you guys been having some trouble here in Seattle, huh? Y'all want to give it up for Donald Trump? Isn't Donald Trump doing so good? Like, subhanAllah, he is doing amazing. Because of Donald Trump, I've seen so many white people come together and say, we are Muslim too. I was like, yeah. I was like, because we need more white Muslims. Is any white Muslims here? I was like, oh man. We need more white Muslims. Like, man, I don't know what happens, but I want us to see more white Muslims. Like, I met one white Muslim, right, when I was young. And there's some, but we need more. And this guy, he was so white. Well, I'm telling you, so white. His name is Ahmed O'Connell, right? Ahmed O'Connell, they told Ahmed, they said, Ahmed, go up and recite Quran. Now listen. Ahmed was so white, even his Quran was white. No, I promise. This is a true story. He got up to recite Quran, and he says, well, sir, inon salamati kosar. I was like, oh. Wow. I really was just looking like, oh, I had never heard white pronunciation of the Quran. Well, sir, inon salamati kosar. I was like, oh my God, Ahmed. You are so white. Alhamdulillah, I like that. We need more white Muslims. Like, I'm so happy that these white people, they came. I wanted to see more of them. They came, they was hanging out with us. White, just, we are Muslim too. Go Shahida. Like, I was like, yeah, I like that. And our sister, man, alhamdulillah, give it up for our sister. She's very strong, our sister, yeah. She's. I know. When she talks, she uses her arms. She's like, we have to be in the house. Okay. Alhamdulillah. I know. Alhamdulillah. And my Arabs. Yani. Habibi. You know, some of my favorite Arabs are Egyptians. I know. Because the Egyptians, they just love to laugh. Like, interesting things. Like Egyptians, subhanAllah, the Egyptians, he told me the story, he said, Omar. The man was walking and the car hit him, boom. And I was like, that's not funny. He says, he went, boom. And I'm just looking at him. I said, well, what happened to the guy? He says, oh, he had to get another car. I said, but what happened to the guy that got hit? Oh, inna lillahi wa inna ilaihi raji'un. And I said, oh my God. And then the other Egyptian chef, he's telling me a story, right? He's telling me the story. He said, Amr, Amr. The man, he taught his horse with dhikrullah. So bismillah means the horse will go. And alhamdulillah means the horse will go fast. And Allahu Akbar means the horse will stop. So Umar, one day he gets on his horse, he says bismillah. And the horse begin to go. And then Umar, he's in a hurry. So he says, alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah. And the horse is going so fast, so fast. But then Umar, he sees the cliff ahead. So he says, Allahu Akbar. And the horse, he stopped right at the cliff. He says, oh, alhamdulillah. Oh, inna lillahi wa inna ilaihi. This is just not funny. Oh man. I like that, alhamdulillah. We hear, we learn, we're eating together, we're talking together. We have different cultures, right? Just different ways we go about doing things. I like it, man, that we learn from each other. Like I've been learning ik do ding ja punch ja sat. I've been learning, man. That's why I've been studying this song. From my Desis, my Indians, my Pakistanis. We're just learning each other's culture. But you guys, we gotta teach you our culture, ourselves, because a lot of us is learning each other's culture from TV, right? So,
you know,
this is a big problem, because I was learning each other's culture, and you know what I thought? I thought like I was speaking the wrong language, I kept doing this. I kept saying, G, Acha, Tika, Tika. What? I said, wow, I got to study this. I need to learn. Because when I'm from the hood, right? I'm from the, you know, Detroit. When I look at my brother from the hood, I do this. Right? And he will respond. So if I see my family from India or Pakistan, I can say. And he will respond to me. So we all like connected. And then I learned from my Arabs, they have like bromance. They like to kiss. The brothers like to kiss the brothers. I didn't know. As soon as the guy came up to me, he said, Salaam alaikum, and he kissed me. I was like, whoo! I wasn't ready. And then he kissed me on my neck. He was a little shorter than me. He said, Habibi. I was like, whoo! I said, oh my God. I didn't kiss him back, I didn't know the Arab men would walk holding hands with Arab men. I didn't know it. I'd never seen it. It's okay. It's the culture. Habibi, alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah. I like it. So good. So we keep learning from each other. But what do you guys know about black people?
I know.
Besides we like fried chicken and watermelon.
I know, that was a test. That was a test. I know, haram.
Even some of my Desis, my Indians, they're looking at me like, dal mein kuch kala hai.
I know. I like to say, sari dal kala hai. Ji,
kala, shakala.
Oh, man.
It's a good time. Y'all like my shirt? Hollywood! Listen, Hollywood is real. I'm really happy to say that we made our first film. How many people know about our first film?
That's 1, 2, 3.
Oh, you guys didn't know? We actually made a movie and we was able to put it in select theaters and Cinemark movie theaters in certain cities inside of the United States of America.
I know.
Now we're making our next film. We're making our next movie. The next movie is called Faithful Neighbors. Faithful Neighbors is an imam, a rabbi, and a pastor. They're neighbors. But they can't stand each other until a devil worshiper moves on the block. And then they're forced to come together. It's another comedy film, alhamdulillah. and we're just gonna keep making a movie every year until Hollywood can stand as strong. Hollywood can stand as strong as Hollywood, Bollywood, Nollywood, and Lollywood. So inshallah, keep making dua for us, Hollywood. If you guys wanna keep follow Hollywood, Hollywood.com. Yes? Okay, all right, that was a commercial. How you doing, sir? Where are you from?
Somalia.
Somalia. Yeah. What's going on in Somalia right now? We need to make dua? Yeah? Alhamdulillah, may Allah continue to bless Somalia and ease them of their pain and their suffering. Say ameen.
Ameen. Ameen.
Ah. You know what? Because I have all of these kids here, you know what I've been focused on? Like, what if we can make the difference between changing some of these songs that all of the kids know, that none of the parents know? Huh, children? Yeah? You know, you guys know Justin Bieber? You know, yeah. You guys know Fetty Wap? You see? You guys know Drake? Haram. Say haram, haram, I say haram. I've been like, instead of, you know what I mean? Like, you know what? We need you guys to change it. Help us change it, right? Instead of juju on that beat, right? Wudu in that sink, right? Making wudu in that sink. Wudu in that sink. Make that wudu in that sink. Right? Yeah, you know it. You know it. I know. Or if Drake was Muslim, well, his song could be something like, started doing dawah, now they're here. Started doing dawah, now my whole team here. Yep, all of my friends makes a lot. Okay, y'all ain't ready for that one. All right, let's do a hotline bling. Do. You used to whip me up for fudge. Now you just pray alone. You used to wake me up for fudge. Now you just pray alone. And I don't want to lose my thing. That can only mean one thing. Yeah. No, I don't want to lose my thing. No. That can only mean one thing. You used to wake me up for fudge. Oh, no. These are the new songs. New songs. Like even me, you know how, sisters, you guys know how sometimes the brothers would like take up the whole masjid. Yeah. And you go in there to pray and the brother is praying on where the sisters usually pray because he don't know, right? Imagine if Adele was Muslim, right? And Adele would come into the masjid and she would look in the brother's and this is the sister's side and she would say, go pray on the brother's side. Quit looking in the sister's eyes. Don't you know that Allah's watching you? And you need to go make wudu. Mm-hmm. Salam alaikum. Rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Okay, all right. You can tell I know the haram version, right? I know. I got issues, man. The way things be happening inside of my head, I'm like, wow. Sometimes I be believing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put me in these situations just because, man. So alhamdulillah, I'm grateful, but you guys gotta make dua for me. Like I don't know what's gonna happen. Like, I remember, you gotta also watch, like, the people you hang around. Like, one of the famous hadiths from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is that you are what your companion is. So whatever lifestyle that your companion is, you are the same. And I used to hang around the bad people, where I would say different, right? I'm learning from them, right? I used to hang around these people. And one time, this guy, he's non-Muslim, I wanted him to be my friend so much, he came to me and shocked me. He says, yeah, Omar, man, I've been studying about Islam. I was like, really? He's like, yeah. He
said, I just got one question for these Muslims. I was like, what? He said, what is the one light bulb?
One what?
One light bulb. I was like, what? That's what I said. What? What? What is this one light bulb? And I was like, I don't, Muslims don't have no thing about one light bulb. He was like, yeah, the one light bulb. I was like, what are you talking about? He was like, I hear it all the time. You guys get on that loudspeaker and y'all be like, one light bulb, one light bulb. I said, no, no, man. It's not, listen, repeat after me. And listen, this non-Muslim guy, true story, was walking around now saying, he was wanting to say the adhan. He was, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, like all the time, because he kept thinking that it was one light bulb, one light bulb. And then, listen, and then his friend came. They had an argument. His friend was like, did you ask him? He was like, ask him what? He was like, oh, about the light bulb. And he said, he was like, oh, yeah, I asked him. He said, it's not a light bulb. He was like, I know I told you it wasn't a light bulb. This is his friend. He was like, they were saying, I like white people. This is true story. True story. Now, both of these guys was walking around. They didn't have Shahada. And they both were saying, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, just from the adhan, thinking, one light bulb, one light bulb. I was like, oh my God, this is so cool. We got to watch the people we hang around. Even I remember when I was young, you guys know how when you're praying now, right? You know when you pray a lot different, you got to concentrate even when you're young when you pray, right? Because when I was little, we used to play around. We'd be praying, we'd be doing this. How are you praying telling everybody else to be quiet? We used to do that, and then we used to do this. Awesome. When we was young, right? So bad. Wasn't concentrating when we was young. I wish that I learned early the importance of concentrating when you pray. Even my sister and them would come and bother me, right? And I would use it as an excuse. I would hurry up when my mother was calling me. She'd be like, oh my! I would run and make sure I love my friends. Whatever she wanted me to do, I'm praying now. And my mother knew this already, right? She knew that already. So she told my sister, she said, oh, what is he doing? She said, oh, he's making salah. And salah be like, yeah, that's right. I'm making salah. Don't mess with me. I'm praying. Allahu Akbar. Right? And then my mother would still say, well, tell him to take out the trash when he's finished. And I would be like, Astaghfirullah. I'm making salat. Like, I would misuse salat all the time. It would be so bad. So I hope now I learned that, oh, salat is so amazing. Like, if you concentrate while you're praying, guys, you can change. You can make a big difference in everybody's life. Just Allah, just concentrate, just be strong. And it only takes a few seconds. Because like if I start my Fatiha all over again, I was praying from Dhuhr all the way to Asr. I would never finish making Salat. It's like, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Oh, I'm sorry, that was a message for the children. So how are we doing over here, guys? How y'all doing? What's going on? Y'all feel good? Yeah? I know. You guys married? We got. Is there any single brothers looking to get married? I'm going to help you out right now. Usually these functions is very good for marriage. So any single brothers there in the back? Alhamdulillah. Yes. There's the brothers there in the back. SubhanAllah. I'm going to teach you something. This is what you need to know. It's going to help you get married, right? You need to learn all about hijab. The fabrics of hijab, and the best gift that you can give the sister is hijab pins. If you learn how,
the hijab pins? Oh my goodness, because the sisters use unique styles with their hijabs. So brothers don't really know about the hijab, but the sisters use unique styles. They just, sometimes they, sometimes they, and then sometimes they put the phone in their hijab. And then they put the phone right there. They tighten it, tighten it, tighten it, Aisha. Tighten it, I have to put my phone here. Bismillah. And they put the phone. Assalamu alaikum. I only want to be there if they get pulled over. Because they can be like, what are you talking about? I'm hands-free. Wa alaikum salam. Hold on, the police are here. I just want to see it. I just want to see it. I had questions. Let me tell you something. Even as a Muslim, like, I had questions for Muslims, but I was scared to ask the question. Like, I was in Saudi, right? And I was like, I wanted to know. Like, I told you, I have these things in my head. I don't know. I wanted to know. I was like, man, I couldn't ask it out loud because people would look at me and say, haram, haram. So I was like, I wanted to know if all of the sisters was wearing burqa and niqab, how does the husband know who his wife is? I was like, I wanted to know. Let me tell you what happened. True story. I came out of Masjid Nabawi. I was in Medina. I come out of Masjid Nabawi. And then I saw this line. It was men that was lined up. They looked just like Salat. They were facing opposite the Qibla though, because we just came out of the masjid. But again, I'm American, so I know if I see a line, somebody is giving away something. I want it. I don't know, I don't care what it is. So I went and I just got in the line. It didn't matter. I'm in the line. And then the line is getting shorter. And there are sisters in burqa and niqab, they're walking through, they're going past, you know. And then I look up and I was like, I saw the brother, this is what's happening. يعني إن تعلم السنة والله والله العظيم يعني إن and then he's gone and then the line gets shorter. تعلم يعني إن والله والله العظيم and then he was gone and then I said, oh wait a minute, he doesn't know who his wife is but she knows him. I was like, oh my God. And so I just stood there and I just watched how these sisters would come and kidnap the brother like a ninja, just take him and take him away. And as I'm in the line, I was like, that is, oh, I got out of the line. I didn't have a wife in Saudi. I was like, what? As I looked up, I was like, dang. And I thought about it. Like, what if you was a bad husband and your wife just left you there? Habibi. Habibi. Aynak. Habibi. I just thought that that was the most unique system ever. Like, subhanAllah. But for the longest inside of my head, I was just sitting there, just wondering, how does this happen? What goes down in Saudi? I also wonder, do y'all wonder when you travel back home now, if anybody has car insurance? I'm so serious. I'm inside that there's no rules in driving. Everybody just go, yellow, 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 yellow. I was asking the brother, I says, do you have car insurance here? Like the man just wrote and they scratched the car. And I said, I said, what is the car insurance here? He says, inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. I just thought it was amazing. I love it. Oh, what else I got going on in my life? So y'all know I did this Chris Tucker thing, right? Can you imagine if Chris Tucker was Muslim, what would he say? How many, wait, first, how many people know Chris Tucker? See, a lot of people think the sheikh is still here. We know, you know, yani, we know. Like, it's Friday, we going to the masjid, we gonna pray all day long, man. Can you imagine it? Can you imagine if Michael Jackson and Elmo and Chris Tucker was in the same room together? And Chris Tucker be like, hey man, we need to do something, man. We need to do something, man. These people is tripping. They're hating on Muslims. And then Michael Jackson would be like, right? And then Elmo would come in and be like,
Elmo says we should all talk in the same law. They should all talk in the same law. In law, in law, law. Oh, my gosh, okay, Elmo.
Right? Imagine that. First of all, why would Michael Jackson sound like that? He talks like this. I can see me singing. But when he sings, for everybody that's studying Arabic, the makhraj is very important for this. You hear it? Let me give you the makhraj. You see the makhraj, يعني هذا. If he yes, if he here, I mean, sah, sah, very good. Adonda, adonda. So you go soft when you go. Adonda. All right, good. So listen, now we can't do everything Michael Jackson did because some of his moves
haram. But we can do this one with this. Alhamdulillah. See the leg? Just the leg. We can do this one. But we can't do the other one. We can do this one. Oh, if the rug was...
We can do it. So imagine Chris Tucker would come in and be like, we're going to have to make a nasheed, man. We're going to have to do this. Make a nasheed for everybody. We can sing this. All the Muslims are going to love it. And Michael Jackson would be like,
and which one would you like to sing?
And then Elmo would be like,
Elmo wants to know the nasheed.
You know, it's so funny. People would be looking at me like, Elmo is black.
I know.
So here's the nasheed. We come up. Michael Jackson's nasheed. Donga.
I'm gonna make a change for once in my life. It's gonna feel real good. I'm gonna make a difference. I'm gonna make it right. And as I turn up the collar on my favorite white suit, Allah is crossing my mind. I see the kids in the street, what are they left to eat? Who am I to be blind, pretending not to see their needs? I'm gonna mix a lot. I'm gonna pray like God. I'm gonna go out and give dawah. I'm gonna say it on the radio, cause I want everyone to know. That's right, I want you to know. Talking to the Muslims in America. Show them that the sun is away. Don't sit there and let them call us a terrorist. Ya Allah, ya Allah, ya Allah.
All right, we're working on that. I think we can start a group. I think I can start a group, man. Did y'all see that video? Allah made everything.
Oh yeah.
How many people seen that? Y'all seen that? Did you guys see the video? Haram.
I didn't see.
I'm gonna make dua. You guys are on my right side too. This is what y'all look like.
Yeah.
G, Acha. Peeker. That's how y'all look. Y'all look like that over there. And then some of you, let's get this phone. Let me see.
QJ Deka.
I'm gonna change my song. Keep it here. Zindagi.
अब तुम ही हो जाना भी मेरे दिल दबी मिया शिकी अब तुम ही हो या ना या
These guys over here, the right is different. I don't know. The right is, let's make dua for them.
Yeah.
Y'all like that? Imagine Michael Jackson. This is what I want you to imagine. Hold on. Let me switch up. How many people know Thriller? Now, instead of doing this, right, instead of doing any of that, this is what we're going to do, okay? I need you guys to make this video, okay? This is what you're going to do. You're going to say, Baba, I need white folds, jupas, or kurtas, okay? Right? This is what's going to happen. Wait, first, how many people know the routine? Be honest, guys. How many you know? All right. Yeah. Good job. Here we go. Here go the hard part. And then remember the words. It's time to fudge up. Muslims, it's time to wake up. It's not a dream, no. And Shaitan is trying to mess you up. Open your eyes and get up and make your fajr. Open your eyes and focus on paradise. On paradise, cause you a Muslim. Muslim, yeah. You pray it to Allah. Every day is to Allah. You a Muslim. Right, and then doom to doom. Another group of brothers come in. Doom to doom. Y'all like it?
Yeah.
Can we do it? Can we do it?
Yeah.
Can we film it?
Yeah.
No? Haram?
Yeah.
They say everything haram. You know, I keep feeling bad sometimes, Muslims, guys. Sometimes I be feeling bad because I be wondering, have anybody really studied the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? Have you studied the Prophet? Did you know he was known not to part anybody without a smile? Y'all know that? Do you know what that looked like? Even when they was like, we're gonna kill you. Yes, it's okay. Did y'all know that? Did you know the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he would laugh sometimes, and sometimes you would see the back of his teeth. Did y'all know that? You know what it looked like? When you see somebody's back teeth? Amazing. Sometimes Muslims have so much laughter back inside of them, it comes out like a dead cough. Like, or sometimes they laugh like they're holding on to their wudu. Yeah, it's so challenging. Sometimes you just gotta, you relax and you let that laugh go. And you feel so much better. You just keep smiling. Yeah? Look like this. See his laugh? See his smile? You see his? Look at this. It's a prestigious smile. It's like a business happy smile. Yes. What is your name, sir?
Wael.
Mela. Oh, Wael. Oh, subhanAllah. Wael. You have done amazing, Mela. Increase your wealth and happiness, and your friend right there. You know this guy right next to you? I was looking at them, I was like, man, he reminds me of like a Muslim Scarface or something. Yeah, he looks like, okay. They want to raise $1 million? Okay. I do it. You know Shaitan? I never loved him. I never liked Shaitan. For all I know, he's the guy distracted me in my salah. Who do I trust? Allah. That's who. You remind me.
Yeah, I know. He was like, you like it? You like that? Yeah, I know. For Allah. Only for Allah. That's right. For Allah. Yeah. Right on. Yeah. He got that. He been hanging around some black people, huh? I know. Did y'all know the Prophet said I'm hanging around a lot of black people? Did y'all know that? Oh, so one sister knew that. Yes! One sister knew that. I know. Like black people, we was in. They only teach us about Bilal ibn Rabah. But if you study, subhanAllah, there's so many Sahaba that was black. Did y'all know the Prophet said I'm married a black woman? A lot of people be like, for real? Say one more. Y'all, did y'all know that? Basically, I'm just telling y'all that. Did you know that the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, when they were scared and they was being attacked, then the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he sent even his daughter for refuge, for safety, to black people? And Abyssinia, Najash, they was all black. Did y'all know that? I know, man. Basically, what I'm just trying to tell y'all is that black is sunnah. I know some people are like, hey, we got ikhtilaf on that. I don't know. All right. I know I've been up here way too long. Haram. And the message. But, yeah. Alhamdulillah. I'm happy to be back in Seattle. I had to work tonight because I know after Salat, everybody was in a different mood. It was interesting. Y'all made me break a sweat. I wanted to have some more fun. I know, but alhamdulillah, I'm really happy. Did they, Brother Mustafa, sir, right here, here I am. Did we get $1 million? So guys, we didn't get $1 million. Like Lil Wayne, we need the million. Is there anybody that can take us to $1 million? We only need like, well, how much more?
170.
We only need 170,000. Starface, salaam alaikum. Who do I trust? Allah! That's, oh. Let's do this, right? Me and you, we can do this? We in there? They call any other? Okay, alhamdulillah. Okay guys, so this is what I need from you guys that's here. We are making this movie. Our crowdfunding starts Monday. So if everybody subscribed, Halaliwood can only, you know why we wasn't able to go in all of the 50 states in America? Because Hollywood didn't believe that Muslims would support their own movies, their own stories. But alhamdulillah, we are here to show them that Muslims will support our own stories. We have to be in charge and in control of us telling our own stories and putting them on the big screen. Do you agree? Okay, they don't agree. This is different. This is different. Oh, they're slow. They're slow. All right. Okay. That was a slow start. I don't know if you was, you know, it's very important. Let me tell you why. Because now, guess what they're doing? Nike come out with the hijab. Did y'all hear about that? Yeah, Nike come out with the hijab. Did y'all hear about this car that they're coming out with now? Catered to Muslims? Did y'all hear about the engineers making the car? Ford has been studying how they can target Muslims for purchase. Did y'all hear about this? Y'all didn't hear about it? With the one brother, where the car will tell you which direction is Salat. And they've been having a discussion on the GPS. If they have the Arab GPS. Did y'all hear about this? The Arab GPS goes, Ba'da Tula Ayameen. Instead of saying we're rerouting, it goes something like this. It says, Tula Ayasar. Tula Ayameen. Ba'da Tula Ayasar. Allah hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Y'all didn't hear about it? Instead of rerouting, he says, La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Guys, man. All right, so listen. What they see is buying power. So they're going to come in and they're going to get rich off of us. But we have to keep the money among us first. Do you agree? All right, so guys, we need you. We built Halaliwood.
And we know that it's a slow start. Our first film, you know, alhamdulillah, it did really good. It did really good. And we'll have it on DVD for everybody. Our next film, we're going higher, stronger, bigger, and better. So go to halaliwood.com and just sign up the mailing list so you can get the updates. And then when we come in, we want to make sure that our movies be in at least every city. So right now I'm in negotiations with Netflix.
Guys,
I know. The number that they brought up in this meeting was $2 million for us to have our own stories on Netflix and on the big screen. So it's very important, the numbers. So if you guys, we need your numbers, inshallah, take a second and follow me on Instagram so I can show. I have some followers, you know, this is what happens. It's all about followers. So alhamdulillah, we've been building this network, and Halaliwood is, we're starting, inshallah. Well, so please go on the mailing list, go on the Instagram and the Twitter, and then just follow at Omar Regan, and inshallah, you'll have all the updates. We're planning to make this movie in July. We'll be filming this movie in July, inshallah, right after Ramadan. And then, subhanAllah, we have 4 Hollywood actors that's asking to be in this Halaliwood movie. Alhamdulillah, because of my relationships with Hollywood, I still have relationships with a lot of the actors and a lot of producers and directors. So, we are doing our best to have them tell our story. In the first film, we had Eric Roberts. And Eric Roberts, you know, he's a legend, right? He's very good. And now, you guys want to know who's in the next movie? I'm serious. I'm going to close out now. You guys want to know? Everybody knows this actor. Do you want to know who's in there?
Yeah!
Okay, you got to follow me on Instagram. And go to Halaliwood and sign up for the newsletter. Inshallah. And Twitter. Okay. All right, inshallah. And Facebook. Inshallah. Thank y'all.
Hollywood isn't like in a halal city.
The kids want to know.
Isn't like in a halal city, you know, like halal.
Hollywood is the movie production company that we're making so that any Muslim, whether they was uncles, aunties, or children, whoever wanted to write, direct, produce, but they couldn't do it because Hollywood is so haram, Hollywood is here now. We're based in Hollywood, Los Angeles, California. But Halaliwood is worldwide. We go everywhere to make a movie. We're making a movie here in the States, but then subhanAllah, we're making a kids movie in South Africa. I know, later this year. So we have so much for our children, so much planned, and that movie is with, Halaliwood is joined with Zayn Beeka. You guys know Zayn Beeka? Yeah, Zayn Beeka Studios. So we come together to make a bigger film in South Africa. So Halaliwood, guys, if you didn't know, just keep saying Halaliwood. Halaliwood?
Halaliwood!
Halaliwood! Means our movies will always be halal, alhamdulillah. And yeah, so inshallah, thank y'all. Don't forget, follow Instagram, Omar Regan. And yeah, you guys put me to work tonight. Alhamdulillah. Thank you all. Shukran. Salaam alaikum.
We have 1.3k views online.
Oh wow.
Thank you to our Sheikh.
It was tough.
You said that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam smiles all the time, right?
Yeah, he used to, he's part nobody without a smile. He would smile at everyone.
Okay, I have a question.
Okay.
And more is he like
$25,000 every day.
I don't know exactly. I just know this.
And your friends spread the word. Tell Peter to donate because
anything from here. Have a bookography program, sir.
السلام
عليكم. الحمد لله الحمد لله.